Awareness is a word that gets thrown around a lot. A lot of people consider Thomas to have been created aware. Looking back at the logs, it seems that awareness only happened somewhere around the network connection spike.
Sarah leaned her wizened head back and laughed. The quadrilaterals were apparently after some friends of theirs. How petty an adventure.
Okay, so we have a couple of people here. We got three people. Oh god, I forgot. Oh, okay, so here is what we're going to do. So the thing about Sarah is that she can pop twice. There we go. That's a little more useful, because that will create a bridge. And that's you. And you. And I believe that Sarah needs to go up and through. Oh dear. I'm lost.
She spoke in terms she could only hope they might understand, of the fountain of wisdom, the channel through which all data flowed.
Okay, so at 6.2 there is a dot here, a collectible. I think I know where it is, but I'm not totally sure. As you can see, I've collected all the stuff before, so my recollection is that it's somewhere out over on this side. Oh boy, I didn't jump a second time. So what's going to happen here is that we're going to go towards the light, Carol Ann. Now, that whole thing that she was talking about with the fountain, we will see that again. It's somewhat important. Not quite important now, but it is important in the future.
Sarah could leap in the very air itself. She was like an eagle or a flea. More like an eagle. She had vowed long ago that she would know this world. She would know what this world was. That she, Sarah, would know how to escape.
Let's do that. Yeah, I thought so. Okay. How do I get... Well, I guess what I can do is do this. There we go.
The Red One, who spoke wisely for a lesser, offered Sarah their help, so long as she then helped them save their friends.
So this one is a slight...
He too had wondered at the secrets of this world, and would quite like a go on the Wisdom Fountain. That was okay. Sarah marvelled at his foolishness, but accepted his help.
And again, it's what they're doing here is very interesting, and it shows a lot of forethought, because they're seeding ideas here for stuff that we're going to see later. Whoops. This is a level I know I don't like, mainly because of the timing, and I'm going to be terrible at it. Come on, there we go. Uh-oh. Don't go. Don't go. Yeah. Uh-oh. There we are. Okay. Upward. Oh god. Uh-huh. Now again, if she gets squished like I was getting squished there, it's very difficult for you to actually do a jump. when that is happening. This is kind of one of my least favorite levels, if only because it's impossible to kind of judge the distances you need to go. Alright, come this way. There we go. So close. Ready?
Come. Sarah wondered at the possibilities of the outer world. She had heard legends of a third dimension. Perhaps she'd encounter one of those curves the blind square had spoken of.
Okay, so the blind square is someone we have not met. I'm just gonna tell you now. That whole setup with the blind squares, it's a little sad. And how we get there is a little sad too. Okay, so that's useful route. If I remember rightly, oh yeah. Oh. This is also a super duper unfun level. Super duper unfun. So the way this level is set up is that there's a bunch of lines, and the only way to jump these lines is to jump absolutely perfectly and at the right spot to make sure that you come up and
a single jump each? These were truly weak creatures. They possessed heart, though. Sarah might consider taking them with her, if they were up to it, which they were probably not.
And as you can see, this is, it's a little frustrating, mainly because you never quite know when Sarah's going to let you do her second jump, like there. I think it's a little easier to do this from the right than it is from the left. But I think this might even depend on which hand you are. So, for example, if you're left-handed, it might be easier to go up the left-hand side. Come on. There we go. And again, I didn't get to do that second jump. And it's almost, but not quite, worth doing. There we go, a jump as far to the right as you can, so you can swing backward, but it doesn't always work out. Mainly because the trajectory doesn't work out, like there. I know, this is painful to watch, I'm sure, but don't worry, it's painful to do. What I might end up doing. I'm doing my second jump. What I might end up doing is I might just cut to the point where I do the one last jump that is perfect. Because this is gonna take a while. Oh. Yep. Okay, so I'm gonna be silent and when I come back, I will have the last perfect jump. Oh, did I speak of it? And it happens. Okay, so what happens now is everything moves. This doesn't make it easier, really, but actually I think I need to be Thomas. Do I? No, I need to be my friend over here. This is a little easier because it gives you enough space for just one jump. And then of course it gets us to a point where we can do Thomas. There is a bit here, but I'm not quite sure where it is.
They were close. Sarah sensed the presence of the fountain. Just one more portal to go, and then she would have the knowledge.
Now, what
and then escape.
What you have to do here is we've got to take Thomas. So we're going to have to jump him, like, on top of Sarah, and then like so, and I'll have to do a thing I don't want to do, yeah. So one of the things they can sort of do, actually hang on. Oh, no, I can't do that with Sarah, because Sarah doesn't have, Sarah's got too much of a jump. There. I need to remember. Okay, there, that's what I wanted. Oh God. Let's not screw it up. That's one of the maneuvers I like the least here. There we go. Let's just get Sarah through though. Because Sarah's sort of easy.
Looked at the glowing beam. That list he'd been writing seemed pretty petty now. This? Well, this was all knowledge. All of it. Right in front of him. He was sorry Sarah couldn't step into it too. He could tell she felt the same way. From the shouting. And the screaming.
Yeah, about this. Oh, come on, Thomas. All I want to do is jump. Okay. Get him there. And... oh God. There we go.
Thomas was connected to the internet for 12 seconds. And he had seen everything. He'd seen the cats who couldn't spell. He'd heard of the arrow through the knee. He felt there was probably a thing called cake, but that it was a lie.
Those are, some of them are super old memes. Let's start there. Sarah's buttons are sort of easy to get. I can probably get these two without too much difficulty. Right. Now, if I remember correctly, yeah, some of them are going to go to the left and some of them are going to go to the right. Ta-da.
Thomas knew where they were. He knew what they had to do. He hoped the others would understand. They were just beyond the next portal.
And of course, here's where we're going to end it for the day once I'm done. So I hope that you are enjoying my friend Thomas. There we go. Can I maybe... wait, hang on. Sarah, you need to go that way. Alright, thank you so much for watching Thomas is Alone. This is episode 7. I'm your host, Lost Wolf, and I hope that you're enjoying this game as much as I am. I shall see you all soon. Have a great evening, folks, and good night for now.